We'll start with interfacing, okay? What do you understand by interfacing? What do you understand by interfacing? Something like, let's say this one is and something, you know, the peripherals or the device is connected to this, right? For example, LCD, keyboard, okay, mouse. 8051 won't have, microcontroller won't have mouse, inbuilt mouse. It need to be externally connected. How it is connected? Through interface. Okay, we need to study that technique called interfacing to connect to the, you know, external devices. Okay, so first one is in your syllabus, okay, stepper motor, interfacing with stepper motor. Now what is a stepper motor? What is a stepper motor? So from the term only, it rotates in step, okay, step. So from motor, from the term itself, right? What is a motor? Motor is something like, is a electromechanical device which converts these electrical signals into mechanical movements. So the shaft, you know, the shaft or the spindle of a stepper motor rotates, okay, when given some electronic or electromagnetic field, okay, originated by this electromagnetic command pulses applied to its, you know, proper sequence. So it has several steps, we'll see one by one. And you rotate beodalu, the pulses will induce some, to the coil, the electrical pulses will induce some electromagnetic field in the coil, and this will attract the poles of the shaft. Okay, animate. So it is a device, stepper motor is a device used to obtain an accurate position control of rotating shaft. It's not shift, shafts. Rotating shafts in terms of steps. That shaft will be rotating, you know, will be rotating in the, rotating in steps. That's why this is called as stepper motor. I hope you have learned this in one of the machine class, right? Stepper motor. So here, stator has a winding. The inner shaft is a rotor. So see here, this is the outside one is a stator. The inner one is a rotor. Okay. So our job is to rotate this shaft, okay, by connecting to microcontroller. So you need, as a programmer, you should write a program in order to rotate this shaft, inner shaft. Okay. Now, how do you do that? Now, first one. First, there are these two steps. See, of three steps. One is stepper motor wave step sequence. Stepper motor wave step sequence. It has four steps. Okay. First, second one is full step sequence, then half step sequence. Then only you'll understand what is this. If you understand these two, then only you'll understand this half step sequence. Now let's look at this wave four step sequence. This is called as wave step sequence. This A, B, C, D are the coil. Okay, these are the coils. Let's say there are four clock cycles. These are cycles, okay? C1, C2, C3, C4. There are four clock cycles. Okay, in the first case, only the coil A is activated. There are four sequences. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's why it is called as four step sequence. There are four sequences. In the first sequence, okay, in the first sequence, only first coil is activated. Only this coil is activated. In this, when it is activated, the position of the rotor or the shaft will be like this. This is step one. Okay. So whenever the coil is activated, that coil will act like a south pole. Okay. That coil, this solenoid, like for example, in this case, C1, remember the A, coil A is activated. So coil A is activated, induced. In some EMF will be induced here in this case, not in the other case. This coil will act like a south pole. You have to imagine that this coil, this solenoid, will act like a south pole. When it acts like a south pole, it will attract the north pole of the, you know, what? Your shaft, your rotor. Imagine that it's something like a magnet inside, right? So the position of the rotor will be as shown in the figure here, step one, okay? In step two, that means sequence two, second coil will be activated. Coil B will be activated. See, step two nalo. That time, solenoid B will be your south pole. So the magnet inside, the shaft inside, will rotate 90 degrees. Okay, there will be angular motion of 90 degrees. So the coil was like this, the coil will become like this. So in the say third step, wait, one call came. Okay. So what is happening here is the sequence, okay? The sequence is continuing here. And as the sequence is continuing, the coil, is being induced, okay? It is creating some magnetic field and it is attracting the rotor. In such a case that the coil inside, the shaft inside is rotating, okay, in four steps of 90 degree angular motion, and it is rotating in clockwise direction. Clockwise direction is meme nani? Anale anna chinche eni denu clockwise direction is meme na? Now, if I continue with this now, after D, chigida A ji machin, if you activate A, that means this rotation will continue. Remember that this rotation will continue. If I continue with this, now A, B, C, D, now again chigi A ji machin, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, bachin, this rotor will continue rotating in clockwise direction. Remember that. Are getting or not? Is it clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I give this sequence, okay, if I have to rotate this rotor in anti-clockwise, okay, if I have to rotate this in anti-clockwise, I will do just opposite. First, I will do D, then C, then B, then A, then D, C, B, A, and B. If I have to rotate, so it depends on the question. If the question asks you clockwise, like this. If the question asks you anti-clockwise, then you have to go like this, right? For first step 4, then step 3, then step 2, then step 1. The row is step 4, step 3, step 2, step 1. It should continue like that. Okay? This is stepper motor, four step sequence, wave step. Second one is full step sequence. Full step sequence nadi, okay? Full step sequence na, see, first step, step number one, step number two, so there are also four sequence here. Four sequence di, okay? Now here, the alignment is not directly to the axis. Let's say this A and C is something like a y-axis and B is something like a x-axis. Now, the alignment is not towards the axis here. It was towards the axis here. Either it was in x-axis or either it was in y-axis. But here, it was not in the axis. Not parallel to the axis. For example, let's say in the step one, sequence one, coil A and coil B is activated. Coil D is activated. B and C is not activated. So the rotor will be facing towards the direction which is between A and D, like this. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Step number two, see, from here it should go analu, A and B, keep analu, North Pole. North Pole will be facing the direction between A and B, not towards the axis, not parallel to the axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, but still, the angular motion is 90 degree. Angular change is 90 degree. Step three, B and C. Coil B and C is activated. So B and C ki banatash. Step four, C and D is activated. So the North Pole will be facing the direction between C and D. That means North East. this is northwest, southwest, south east, southwest. This is second full step. First one was wave step sequence, second was full step sequence. Now if I combine these two, if I combine wave step sequence and full step sequence, we will get half step sequence. In half step sequence, there will be 80 steps. Okay, there will be 80 steps. Now if we look this 8 steps, 1, 3, step number 1, step number 3, step number 5, step number 6. These are your full step sequence. Step number 2, step number 4, step numbers, even numbers. Even numbers, step number 2, 4, 6, 8 are wave step sequence. Now, if I combine all these, the rotor, you know, the shaft inside will be rotating clockwise, but in the angle change of 45 degree now. It was 90 degree change here, the rotating in each step was taking 90 degree, but here each step will take 45 degree angle. As you can see, in the first step, 10001, this case A and D ki banai me mena ana. Okay, 10 ana. Step number 2, only 1 towards A ki side na. Step number 3, AB ki side na. Step number 4, B, aligned to the B. Step number 5, B and C ki bana. B and C, where is B and C? B and C, B and C ki bana. So as you continue after 8, if you continue with step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, daru 1, 2, 3, 4, continue, bebe joachin. This shaft will rotate clockwise, okay, in the step of 45 degree. Okay, are you getting? If you want to rotate this in anti-clockwise, it would be just opposite. Just opposite. 8 will be step number 1, 7 will be step number 2, 3, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There are 8, 7, 6, and whichever. If you want to do in anti-clockwise. Is it clear till this point?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
This is very simple. Your subject only. Now, okay. Now, if I want to rotate like this, and this has to be controlled by microcontroller, I will send a value 1000. Okay. I'll send a value, a lower nibble. This will be lower nibble. 1000 value. What is this value? This is in hex, binary. Hexa gachi maani ki 10000. 8. Yes. 08H I will send in accumulator. What is this value? 01C00.
4.
Yes. So similarly, like that, somewhere I had written here. Analo. Yeah. This is full step sequence. Tame, Ana. Full step sequence. Labdalu, this is wave. Ana, there's a mistake here. This wave step sequence, this one. Wave step A, B, C, D. May. Instead of A bar, B bar, you put C, D here. 100 di 080 hex value. Step 2 gi 0100 is 04. 3, 02. This one, 01. What about full step sequence? 11 bewachin 0C. 11 is, what is 1100? Decimal number 1100.
12
is C. So lower nibble. I'm talking about lower nibble. Me. This one is a lower nibble. So 1100, that means 0CH. If it is 0110, it will be 06H. So each step, we have already studied this, right? This is half wave step sequence. This one is full step sequence. Now, if I combine these two, it will be half step sequence. That means there will be 8 steps, each comprised of the hex value. And I have to send this value to accumulator if I want to rotate the rotor. Is it clear? So it depends on the question. You want to rotate the shaft with step of 45 degree angle, or you want to rotate the shaft with 90 degree. Which one you want to do? Okay. So I write a question on a loop. First, I did only for, I think only for clockwise. Full step gi denu chamchi being agi. Wait, 06, 06, 03, 09, 06, 06. Yeah, I did for this one, Anna. For this one, I'm talking about this one, full step sequence. You can try for other. You can try for half wave. It works. I did for this one, particularly this one. So I need to send these 4 values, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to send these 4. 0C, 06, 03, 09. So this is how we got this value, 0C, 06, 03, 09. Okay. Now, ORG00H, main, always we start with 00H. Then I move the value to accumulator, like I said. Okay. First value is 0C, because in the first step sequence, 0C, memenana, 0C. And a 0C move in the accumulator. From the accumulator, I'll send to port 2. Okay. From the accumulator, I send to port 2. So your port 2 becomes your input. That means your motor, your stepper motor will be connected to port 2. Okay. And I'll tell you, when I draw this in Proteus, you need one interfacing IC. Okay. Or driving IC. I mean the driving IC. You need one driving IC. So port 2, this value will be sent to A, and A will be sent to port 2, because in the port 2 you will be connected with the rotor, okay, motor. Then I'll give some delay, because in each step ki change zone denlo, you require some delay, you require some time from position A to step 1 to step 1 zone denlo. I need some delay. Step 2 to step 3, I need some delay. Continue Joachindi, we'll never see, okay? What is the, whether it is going in step or not. So in order to have some interval between this step, I give some delay, okay? So see, after the delay, I send next value. So let's say this is step 1. This is step 2, there is delay, then step 3, there is delay, step. So 1, 2, 3, 4. There are only 4 steps. So 4 step means this is full sequence or half sequence, half step sequence. Full step sequence or half step sequence?
Full step.
This is full step sequence. So I give delay. See, this program is also very easy. Full step, and this is for clockwise. This is for anti-clockwise. See the difference. 0C, 06, 03, 09 G again for clockwise. In anti-clockwise, first you will give 09, then give 03, then you will give 06, then 03. And this should continue imabade. This should continue. That's why this should be in a loop. So that's why I put there, after a called delay s jump main. So main beyodalu, it will come back here. So this will inside, this will run in the infinite loop. Okay, anidi. Now I give a delay. Okay, delay, it depends on you. This one I've given some random values. Analu, I have created three nested loop. You can give any values, it depends on you. This one just randomly jing agiana delay thi. Just randomly I've given. You can just give 0ffh, 0ffh also. It's okay. You can try. Okay. It need not be same as mine. You know how to use DJNZ. So there you use two nested loop or one nested loop. Okay. It's okay. I have used two nested loop here. Okay. Are you getting or not? This is the delay. So delay is a subroutine here. Imimena. And if I put this return, it will always come back. Always subroutine will be end with return, right? So this is the end of the program. And if you connect in Proteus, okay? In the Proteus, you will be connecting like this. So this is your 8051, okay? This one will be your 8051. This one will be your, what is that? What is this? Stepper motor, Anidi. Okay. And this one will be your driving IC, driving motor, motor driving IC, because microcontroller won't be able to give that much of power to drive your motor. So what it will do, it will interface with one IC. That one is ULN2003A. You can do it one another one. L293, this is also motor driving IC, L293D, and this one is also motor driving IC. Okay, and I told you it will be connected to port 2, because in the question, in the program, I have written port 2, Anna. Okay, so port 2 nalu connected here. Are you getting? So this driving IC will be connected to the port 2. 16, 15, 14, 13 will be connected. Pin number 16, 15, 14, 13 will be connected to your IC, motor. So in the motor, Daru, there will be 4 pins for input and 2 pins for driving, actually. 4 pins. Another 4 pins for to rotate this, okay? The AC connection supply. And 4 for the, you know, the input. 4 for the input to the motor and 4 pins for the supply of the motor. Are you getting? Is it clear till here before I go to now Proteus? Any doubt, imagine all lost to that. If there are any doubts. Any doubts till this point? I hope you are following, not sleeping. Till this point, am I clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I think this diagram is not relative here. This diagram is of next practical. So I'll give this. I'll go to a Proteus. Okay, come here. Those who have not installed, please install it. I'll try to contact with Jamjo sir. Okay, and I'll try to put that software in FTP server. Meanwhile, you can also get it from internet, Google Nalu, and free. Okay. But whether you'll get cracked version or not, that I can't say. Meanwhile, I'll do my thing, okay? So this is when you open Proteus, it looks like this, okay? It looks like this. It'll directly go to new project here, Anna. New project.
So I can't see the screen, sir.
Oh, yeah. They may. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
They may. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir, yes.
When you open a Proteus, the window looks like this, Anna. Okay. You go to new project, Anna. Something is wrong. It's hanged. Okay. You go to new project. Tomego is Mothoma Jen Lab Mangalo. New project. Tuga. Delay. Okay. New project. Next, Anna. You give a name, any name. Let's say, what is this project? Motor. Motor interfacing. I give a name. It is located in documents. Okay. Next. Create a schematic. Anna, click. By default, put a default here. I don't want a PCB layout, so do not create PCB layout. Okay. Here, create firmware project. You click this. And I'm right now, I want to deal with 8051. So you find Atmel 8089C51. This one. So if I do this, you will come to this window. This window. Is it visible?
Yes, sir. Once again, sir.
This one. Redo.
Oh, sir.
Rame. New project. Okay. First, Nalu. New project. You give any name here. Let's say motor interfacing. Record beja, screenshot beja. That is upon you, okay? New project, next. Create a schematic from the selected template, Anna, default. You give it default. Next. I don't want PCB layout. You don't have to study. EC should study this PCB layout. So do not create PCB layout. Next. Create firmware project Nalu. It is it's not necessary, but, you know, we have an option here directly, which microcontroller you want to work with. So directly you can say that you want to work with 8051 because you know it, right? 8051. When you do this, you'll get this screen. No, you'll get this screen. This is your 8051 microcontroller. Till now, you were studying this IC. It looks very small, but very powerful. It might be less than 1 inch, half inch, practically, but very powerful. This is your 8051. Okay. Now, let's, this blue mark, thoing ane blue mark, blue ane.
Yes, sir.
Blue line. Did you see this? This blue line is your, you know, that PCB layout, PCB boundary, and this one. You can go out of this, but when designing, it should be inside this design. But simulation, okay, you can get, you can do anywhere. But when you do simulation, this box, this whole design should be inside this blue box. I'll move here somewhere here. Now, what all we need? What all things we need? Yeah, before that. Yeah, before that, I'll tell you. I'll go to Kale. That program is here. Me stepper motor ki. Stepper motor ki program ana ding already. I explained you already. Me. Ani program di. That's ki program. Ani program di. Please listen very attentively. Me. And this step is very important. If you miss one step, you will not be able to do it in Proteus. I'm telling you. This program, the stepper motor ki program di. I'll write it in Kale. Okay, now it is very important for you to convert this file into hex file. Stepper motor nothing else. That khacha itne lapche mein analu. Analu the hex file dumb bego. Say practically you will do that with a burner. IC burner the chika biyong thegi. Program di chegi IC na burn biyong. In electronics lab we do that. Okay, next time when you come I'll show you how to burn. Ani sangi demagi. I see na program gadi be burn bio. Most of you must be unaware of this. Anybody knows? Did you burn a program in IC?
No, sir.
This program need to be burned in IC. Any program di it should be dumped in IC. How you do that? With the use of IC burner in lab. But in this Proteus, we do that by, you know, there's one some step here. I'll show you. The program burn beni e salabachini daru. You can't directly get this. You can't burn direct. You can't dump this directly. This program directly into the IC. You need to convert this, you know, code into machine code. That is your hex file. Then you have to dump in the IC. So hex file na convert back away. Before that, you need to go to peripherals. Anna. Somewhere not peripheral. This one. This part. Target option. Can you see that here? Target option. Somewhere it must be here also. Yeah, here. Option for target. Anna. Project na jo. Option for target. You go here. You go to output. Anna. Output nalu here. Create hex file. Say. Did you see? Anna. If you don't click this, when you run, hex file won't be created. If you tick this, hex file will be created. Is it clear? So yes. I have ticked this. I'll tick OK. Okay. Darume na project na jo option for target and option for target output file na tick this. Create hex file. Okay. After clicking that hex file notation, I'll run this program. When I run this program, this file will be automatically converted to your hex file. When I run this, okay, no error. I don't want to see the debug now. Okay, debug now you can see, but I don't want to see, okay, because the program is right. You can check it out, okay? Debug no job. But right now, I'm more interested in to put this file into Proteus. Now, hex file has been created. If you see down here in the output, creating hex file from stepper motor seduana. So your hex file has been created already, okay? Where it is created, where you have saved this file, there you have created. For example, I have saved this file somewhere here. Okay. I have saved this file here. Analu, you have a hex file somewhere. Where? Here. Steppermotor.hex. The extension is hex. This is the file which we need. This is your hex file. Is it clear till this point?
Yes, sir.
This code will be converted to hex file. Where it will be converted? In the file which you have saved. Okay? In the file which you have saved. Right now, my hex file is somewhere here because in this folder I had saved. Now, please remember the position of this hex file. We need to put this file in this 8051. Okay. So let's bring some components. What are the components we need, Anna? 8051 chamchi ki mito bate. What all we need, Anna? Dachi.
Motor and motor IC, sir.
Yeah, so one motor and one motor IC I need. ULN2003A. How you'll bring the component? Anna, click P. Click P. ULN2003. Which one? Ani memena. ULN2003A. Yeah. You double click this, it will come here. What are then a motor? Stepper motor. Is it connected? So one of the I think this one. Anime. And the L297. This the, you can use with this IC also. It's okay. Anime. Okay, double click. Double click bechai. Now you tick this. That thing will come here. This is your motor. This is your driving IC. Okay. Now, according to the program, it need to be connected to which pin, which port? Port 2. Anna, port 2. Where is port 2? Here. So, port 2. Okay. Port 2 will be connected like this. This is how you connect, Anna. Practical begome ache ki ane, Anidi. Port 3. Port 2.3. Okay. This is how you connect. Then 16. Will go here. No. Tele. 15 will go to this pin. 15, pin number 15. Go here. 14 will go on the down. Okay, 14 will go here. 13 will go to the top. 13 will go to the top here. Okay, delay, I need some source and ground. This is, we'll get somewhere from here, yeah, analog. So input, this is your AC source. If you want to rotate anti-clockwise, clockwise, if you want to rotate like this. Anna, this one should be connected to your anime mena or the AC source. Wait. Tell me. Okay. Dile, what are the connection we need to do? U1, I think this is it. Dile, you can do some more complicated connection using crystal oscillator. This you use, baby. You can do. Okay. Then, okay. This is just a demo for you. Now I'll put the code here. Just click this. Anna, how to put the code here? Hex file. Anna, look. Kadi bechuni. Anna, double click this. Go to the file where we have saved that hex file. Okay, hex file gati shape bechigi. For example, SS microcontroller somewhere here. Anna luchigi hex file do. So you double click this. Okay, so your hex file is here now. If I do this, it's not rotating because there is something problem with the supply. Stop it, Anna. Play, stop, pause is here. May could not get AC. Dime. I think this connection is not there. Anidi. This one is the one. Dile, what all I missed? I don't remember now. Yeah, now it's rotating, right? AC ki aana hai me aana. This is for AC signal. Ground this. I didn't ground and all actually. Ground this the motor tub actually. For ground. When you do this, no. But it's not rotating. Something is, it's the problem. Check it out. So, I have done here correctly. Dime. You connect like this because of the crystal oscillator, this bago, 10 this capacitor bago, in order to balance the EA pin. Reset pin gidenlo ani ni go vade. This is your, what is this? Yeah, power man. Ground will look like this, and ground, this is ground, this is power, Anna. Everything power, ground, input, output you'll get from here. Okay, Anna le top chahiye. You connect like this, not the one which is like this. Analu. See. I've dumped the code already. Crystal oscillator, you'll get from. Analu, crystal oscillator, you go here. X1 crystal. No. This one, Anna. Pinojo, CRYSTAL crystal. This one. Okay, this is crystal. Capacitor. Capacitor. Anna, this is the capacitor. How you will change the value of the capacitor? How you change the value of the resistor? Double click here. Change the value here. 10 nanofarad. How you change the value of this resistor? 10 kilo ohm. I've already done the file. Okay. I'll give some AC supply. AC supply is somewhere here. Man. AC supply is confusing. Anna, this is your AC supply. Coming back. This one, the components you have accumulated is this box. AC supply is this box. Ground, ground. AC, DC supply, this one. This is DC, sine wave, pulse wave, what kind of pulse you want? Ramp signal. Ground supply, this one. This one. So, if I on this, it should rotate. Okay. See, this is full step or half step? Full step or half step, Ani?
Full step.
This is full step, yes. So this is how you do interfacing of what is that stepper motor.
Sir.
Yeah.
And hex file the kadevichuga search
yes. Yeah, hex file is you click double click here. Analu, IC Nalu, you double click. You go to this and a program file nalu ana hex file chuchu yebatana. You browse here, kati na X file, chahi, kati save bhej jayega. You okay. Double click and okay, open. This is how you do.
Okay, sir.
Any other doubt? You will do this. You will install your what is that? Proteus. I'll put this Proteus software in FTP and I'll give you the link of your link of that software to I think amchi pevachin to this is you know in after connection of this is just a simulation imedaru the practical nalu I don't know whether you have stepper motor in the lab or not stepper motor ega lab na I don't remember.
Mila, sir.
I don't think, yeah. DC motor, I think DC motor is also not there, I think. DC motor, AC, DC motor and stepper motor is frequently used in this electronic projects. Real time, chegi ani beni ma chindi, you need to connect with the relay, and a relay connect big one. Real time fan the chica connect beni and zoom watching. Okay, I think for today this much. Okay,
sir. Today, sir, can also upload this video also, sir.
Yeah. Upload beja hai na. Record the being aki. Okay. The car mo absent di. Demi.
Stop recording.
Everybody is present. One absent. Kamu. किले वांछु इमे किले वांछु इमे में ना
मे सर
किले वांछु इमे ओके आई विल अपलोड दिस तो because ani you might need this ani protease can yes, screen
thank you sir
yeah
thank yes, you sir
thank you sir
ah entered the host name me